guys, what's up? So, this is going to be part two to the Water Dragons Road to Recovery. If you haven't seen the first part, it'll be right here. It'll be like a link type thing that you should click and go watch the first part probably before you watch this, because it'll explain what's going on. Alright, so basically what we're doing today is I'm doing my daily care for the Water Dragon, who needs to be soaked, given his shot, given his oral medication, and given his food, which is a little different than usual. So I'm going to show you guys how I'm doing all this, and let's get started. Alright guys, so as you can see, the Water Dragon is just chilling in the corner, not feeling that great, and you can see his eyes are still closed, and he is just not looking that great. So what we have to do, we have to give him these medicines. Okay, so we're actually going to be giving him three different things. Right here we have shots, which is going to be the first thing I'm going to do. And here we have oral antibiotics that I will be giving him second. And lastly, I'm going to be giving him carnivore care, which is basically a powder made of all sorts of proteins and vitamins and calcium and all sorts of good things for him that when mixed with water turns into almost a baby food consistency. And from there I give it to him by oral syringe, and this is actually really good for recovering or sick animals, but I'm not sure you can actually just get this. I've only gotten this from my vet, so you can talk to your vet if you have a sick animal or recovering from some sort of surgery or something. But this is going to be the last thing we're doing, so let's get down to business. But before any of that happens, I actually have to soak the dragon in warm water for about 10 minutes. Let's get started. Give a little guy his shot. So I'm gonna move this, try not to spill it. Well, damn it. Alright, so let's get the camera set up a little bit better and then we can show you him getting his shot. Alright guys, so when you're holding them, you actually want to have their legs kinda folded back, almost as if they're in a swimming position, so they have their legs kinda up against their body so they can't squirm quite as much. And I'm actually gonna be giving the shot right here, right in the front side, right up against the crest. So I'm gonna grab it and I'm gonna kinda show you what I do. And this is by no means an instructional video to go out and start giving your lizard shots. Definitely want to be taught by a vet. And you definitely don't know necessarily how or where you're supposed to give it unless you talk to your vet. Alright, in this guy's particular case, this is how it is supposed to be done. Alright. So basically, the syringe, I don't know if you can even see it. I'm attempting to get it into focus. Well, you aren't going to be able to see it really that well. But basically, there is a kind of a angle at the very end. What I like to do is bend it, bend the tip toward that angle. So what I can do is actually have it at an angle as I'm giving it. Alright, I'm going to try and get it as visible as possible. And you just want right under the skin and put it in there. Alright. And there you go. I don't know how on film that was. You can see a little bulge right there from where the shot was given. And then you want to basically cover it again. And if that was all you were supposed to do, you're basically good to go. And you can put it back in its cage and just kind of monitor it, make sure it's doing good. But unfortunately in this case, this little guy needs to have his oral medication too, so I'm gonna show you how we're gonna do that too. So I'm getting one of these guys out. He's all back. And this is really, really pretty stressful on them, so you want to try and make it as stress-free as possible, which, I mean, is tough. But basically, what you're going to want to do, I know, bud, I'm sorry. As you can see, these ones don't actually have a syringe. It's just like a, it's just to inject it into his mouth, basically. And what I'm going to try and do is get him to open his mouth as best as I can. Sometimes rubbing along the side of their jaw, they'll open their mouth. Yeah. And you're going to hold them up, facing up like this, so they actually are forced to swallow it, basically. And just gotta inject it in. And it's pretty sweet. This stuff at least is. So they shouldn't really have any problems with it, but I mean, they're going through a lot of stress and may have problems digesting or swallowing if they're really sick. So there's that issue. Alright. And that's basically for right this second. That is it. And I'm going to put him back in the cage. Let him kind of take a break from that, take a breather. And I'm going to show you guys how I prepare the carnivore care.